Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making peanut butter log, and it's a log shaped piece of candy, but it's going to get sliced. So it'll be in little pinwheels actually when we get it finished, and it's a very attractive confection, and it's something that you can serve at parties. And I'm trying to do a few party things, and I was trying to think of something sweet because you don't want cake or pie or pudding or something like that. So just a little pickup finger food that is easy to manage and also tastes good and looks pretty. So let's start with a large mixing bowl. I'm going to use my electric mixer, and I'm going to have some confectioner sugar, and that can fly all over the place, so I need a large bowl. Thought about getting out my bigger mixer, but this is not that big of a job. It's just a matter of containing it all in one spot. What I'm going to begin with in that mixing bowl is Philadelphia cream cheese. It doesn't have to be this brand, but I got regular this time instead of fat-free. The reason being that we want this to hold together really well, and if you're substituting, that'll be fine, except it may not hold together as well as if you get the full fat cream cheese. Now, this is a whole block of 8 ounces, but I used only half of it. And I will tell you, I'm only making half of a recipe. Rick and I can't eat everything that I cook around here, particularly the sweets. So a lot of times I will take a recipe, if it's not a large item like a cake, and I will cut it in half. And I will tell you that so you could just double it, everything, if you want to have the full recipe. Or sometimes I write it up as the full recipe, but warn you ahead of time. But this time I'll just write it up like I'm doing it, and you can see how much it makes. If you need more, then that's your own judgment. I'm going to put some salted butter in, and this is 1/2 stick. And you can see that these have been sitting at room temperature. Doesn't really look like half stick because it's a strange shape, but this is the same as 1/4 cup of butter. So we have those two items that we can just mash together, and they are so soft because they are at room temperature. This is kind of hard to do if you don't soften the butter and cream cheese at the beginning. And I will tell you that this mixture is just about exactly like the frosting that I put on my carrot cake, which is a cream cheese frosting, and I'm sure a lot of you are familiar with cream cheese frosting. So that tastes really good. But we want to proportion the sugar that goes in with the butter and cream cheese in such a way that this will be stiff enough that we can make it into a log. So we're going to use one whole box, which is a 16-ounce box of confectioner sugar. Now that's the same as powdered sugar, and some of you call it icing sugar. So what I'm going to do is put this in a little at a time, and then I'm going to be beating with my electric mixer. So just starting with about that much, I'll get you started, and then I'll finish up away from you, and when we come back, I'll have all that beaten together. But here's a start. That's finishing up, and your beaters will get kind of stuck down in there, so you kind of pull away without flinging it all over the room, and then just set that aside. And what you have is a mixture that is stiffer than your icing mixture when you put these three ingredients together. And that's nice, because what we're going to do is to get this out on a piece of wax paper, and then we'll shape it by hand into a rectangle. So I'll just take this ball and put it out there. It's kind of heavy. Just right in the center. And remember, this is just half of what you would have if you did the whole recipe. So I would suggest that you make two rectangles and put it on two separate pieces of wax paper if you make the full recipe. But here we go. And what I'm going to do at this point is take off my rings. I don't think you would want your rings on if you're working with some icing or candy like that. Can I get this ring off? I guess it's stuck, Rick. That's why we've stayed married 41 years. Couldn't get my ring off. There we go. Okay. So I'll bring this closer to me. Move this out of the way. And I did wash my hands before I started all of this. So sometimes you just really have to get in there with your hands and do part of the work. So you want to flatten this out. And as you flatten, shoot for something that looks like a rectangle. And I would say if you get it like 1/4 or 3/8 inches deep, that's about right. So let me go ahead and get this done. I'll come back and show it to you. I have this candy, or icing, or whatever you want to call it, rolled about as thin as I can get it and expect to be able to make it into a roll. The next thing is to take peanut butter, about 1 cup. This is just some reduced fat peanut butter, and I've measured out 1 cup, and I have a spreader, and what I'm going to do is come down and get some of this. It should be at room temperature, and you'll notice that I have some powdered sugar here. I actually used a dough roller in order to speed things up, and this is not a perfect rectangle or anything, but once we get it rolled properly, then we can just cut off the edges and everything will be nice and pretty. But we'll be spreading all of this with peanut butter, and that's a little tricky because it doesn't want to stick that well, so it's going to be a painstaking chore, but I'll go ahead and do that. Just assume I have it done. Then what we're going to do is roll it. I would pick this longer direction and go with it, and you can actually use the paper underneath to help you along, and then you want to let it loose from the paper as you go, and it will loosen up like that. So imagine it getting spread, which I will do next, and then getting rolled. And I'll come back to you when I get that done and we'll finish it up. I'm finishing up here and getting this covered with peanut butter, and I'm trying to get it all about the same thickness. And once you get started, it's pretty easy to do. It's just getting it to stick at the beginning, and then once you get it started, the peanut butter sticks to itself really well. So just keep putting peanut butter on top of peanut butter and then sliding it across until you get toward the ends. So we're going to start rolling this, and I'll just start over at this edge. Remember, this doesn't have to be perfect. It will still look really pretty when it comes out in the log. So I'll do the beginning of the log, but then I'll probably need to go away and fidget with it a little bit in order to get it perfect. I think I'll just take off this extra edge here. I don't think we need that. It makes a nice scrap to eat sometime. And what we want to do is roll tightly, and you can use that paper to bring it up, but then you don't want to get the paper caught in it, so let the paper go like this once you get it rolling. But you can continue to use that paper to make your roll and just pull it away as you go. And if it slows down, then you might want to stop using the paper and use your hands, or maybe come up in the other direction if you get that close. You can even go a little bit farther this way and peel the paper off. And you can see we're coming to the edge, so we're finishing up. And what we want is a seal here, so just take your fingers and kind of seal that down. Now, to make it pretty, I don't have a knife here, but I'll use this spreader. I'm just going to take this off of it. And magically, a knife is appearing in front of me. So I'm just going to cut this off. That looks like a lot of excess, but it will not go to waste here, I'm sure. And over here, this is not very pretty either. So you want your roll itself to be very pretty. So what I'm going to do is get a sharp knife and try to make this a little rounder, and then get a nice plate to put our results on, and I'll show you the result in just a second. One thing I forgot to mention is that Rick and I decided that we wanted to roll this peanut log in pecans. That's an optional step. If you don't like the pecans, it's not a necessary part of the recipe, but we use these fancy pecan pieces. They're not that fancy, it's just they're chopped pecans, and that's what we get at our grocery store. And I've put some out on wax paper here, and to make this easier to work with, I'm going to take a knife and just split this down the center, because we're not that concerned that we come out with a perfect log. What we want to do is to have the individual pieces. So I'm just going to show you what this looks like if we pick up half of it. If you try to pick it all up to roll it in the pecans, it's going to sag in the middle and be very difficult. So you just need to saw your way through, and then you can roll one piece away from the other. And you can sort of see what it's shaping up like, but it should look prettier than that when we get finished with it, because we're going to refrigerate it actually. And the hard part of working with all of this has been that it's at room temperature and it's very sticky. But when we refrigerate it, it's all gonna solidify. You know, that butter was just almost melted. I hadn't microwaved it or anything. It's just been sitting at room temperature, but it was so soft, and the cream cheese was so soft. But when they get refrigerated, they're going to go back to their original form, and they'll take this candy with it. So you just roll. Maybe we'll do one that's rolled and one that's not. What do you think about that?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So I had out 1 cup of nuts, and it looks like I put about 2/3 of a cup down on this piece of paper. So just however much you want. If you want it thickly covered, then just keep rolling until you get it very thick. If it doesn't matter to you, if that's enough, then you'll use much fewer pecans than what I got out there. And you can take it and take them and put them on the top and pat them in a little bit and then roll and get more, because they don't necessarily pick up that well when you just roll. Just keep doing that. And what I'm going to do next is actually chill this. And then I'll cut it, because it's going to be so much better if you have a chilled log and then you slice down neat slices, because it won't want to run together and ruin those spirals that will form. So I'll have to come back after a while, after this is nice and chilled, and show you the final result. I had divided my candy into 2 rolls, and one roll I decided not to put any pecans on the outside. The other roll has pecans, and I've chilled these a bit, and they're to the point where I can cut through them nicely with a chef's knife. So let me just show you how that goes. This is kind of elongated, but it doesn't really matter. It doesn't have to be a perfect circle. So you're just going to go down, slice like that, and there's the look that you get. It should be a nice spiral. So you can bring it over to your candy dish or candy plate. I think I'll make these go toward the outside, because we're going to have quite a few of them. And just keep doing that. You can see what they look like. I'll finish that and put them on the candy dish. For the one with pecans, it's a little harder to go down through there, because you're going to have to cut through pecans. But pecans are stuck on there, and they look really nice. So that might be an option that you'll want to try. So let me go ahead and do this, and then I'll show you our finished result. Here's what our finished peanut butter log candy looks like. It's really pretty, and you'll notice that these are kind of big in comparison to these, and I'll tell you why. When you put those pecans on the outside and you roll the log in pecans, the pecans don't stick very well, so you'll find that you're kind of pressing it down, and it's elongating, making a longer log, and you'll get more of them, but they're smaller. And that's because of just pressing those pecans in on the outside. So if you're looking for a little treat for your party or for any time, if you like candy and you like the peanut butter flavor and the cream cheese flavor, that frosting sort of flavor, then I think you'll like these, and I hope you can use them.